Rachel are both going to a hospital, but we're going for maybe the same reason. We kind of have different jobs, right? I'm a doctor, you're a writer, but we have some similarities. And my job as a radiologist is to take pictures for a living, I sometimes joke, and then I have to explain those pictures to other people. How about you as a writer?
Well, it's kind of the same thing. I take complex ideas about healthcare in this case and make them simple in a way that lots of people can understand. And I also help people in different roles to work towards a shared vision. So like healthcare innovators and doctors.
We're taking a bus in the interest of sustainability, which is super easy here in London. Where are we going?
We're going to visit some doctors to find out how our latest Philips innovations are helping stroke patients.
It's funny that you talk about stroke because we have a next generation of Zorion that we just launched, and it's all about stroke. In fact, as you know, we were together talking to some journalists yesterday, and I was explaining to them how stroke is the number one cause of disability all over the world. How is it here in the UK?
One person every 5 minutes has a stroke here in the UK.
Every 5 minutes?
Yeah.
Are there enough practitioners to take care of all these people?
No, and as you say, often at all, time is brain. The quicker we can treat a stroke patient, the better their chance of recovery.
So how did you come to Philips? I mean, you weren't always in healthcare, right?
No, I wasn't at all. I was a business journalist, but then I was a fashion journalist.
Fashion?
Yeah.
So where were you working?
I was working for Women's Wear Daily in Paris.
And wow, yes, so you did a lot of traveling.
I did, yeah. I went to a lot of fashion shows, interviewed celebrities.
Were the models just as much of a diva as the doctors are?
No, the models were awesome.
were they even less?
They were really nice. Okay. And the celebrities were lovely.
You must have met a lot of interesting people.
Yeah, I did. I met Pink, the Harry Potter stars, but my all-time favorite has got to be Sir Paul McCartney.
You've met a Beatle?
I have met a Beatle.
You know, we just passed Abbey Road Studios, and I have to tell you, I'm a massive Beatles fan. I had every demo.
Are you?
I had every bootleg. How did you meet Paul McCartney?
Well, he was at Stella McCartney's after-show party, and I was talking to his son, James, and I think he thought I was James's girlfriend, so he came up and gave me a massive hug, as if to say, welcome to the family.
Wow. But my nephews and nieces, they're massive Harry Potter fans. So tell me, did you learn any magic?
No, unfortunately not. But there's definitely overlap between the amazing visual effects in Harry Potter and what's just around the corner for IGT and the world of surgery. So think about AI, AR, virtual reality.
Robotics,
exactly.
Yeah, all that stuff is pretty magical.
It is pretty magical. And imagine, like, in a couple of years' time, you could be wearing 3D augmented reality glasses that will help you to treat patients. I mean, that's amazing.
That's the future of IGT.
Yeah, absolutely.
And you left all of that for healthcare for Philips. Why?
I did. It was exciting, but I just think you need purpose in your job, and Philips has an amazing purpose.
Beep, 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 yeah! And now, you're in the know.